once more as they begin with a first and 10. Flush to his right.
Paralyzed Gaming Yoda.
Steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad. That's an end. Feel pretty good about it. The people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Hopefully you win it.
Come up first and 10 now from the 33.
I thought to myself, I'll automatically practice for a little while.
That's
complete to his running back. Oh no, he lost the football.
Got you, bitch.
Get in position to win the game.
His stick fumble, baby.
Start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Play action now, Prescott. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. Boy, 30 more yards and another first down.
Come on, baby. Come on, Prescott. Give me a game-winning drive, baby. Come on.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. A first down carry by Elliott. And he's brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Prescott down. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. Touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Offense set to begin their next possession, and now they'll look to answer working from behind. And remember, this offense is sputtered yet to
score. Boy, I come with the motherfucking hit sticks, my nigga. Lay no ass out, bitch.
On the pick up there, it'll be second and eight.
And sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the improv. And you run into a tough crowd.
Brady's throw taken in by Evans here.
Come on with the hit sticks, baby boy. I'm laying these motherfuckers out.
That'll put him at 66 receiving yards now for the game. And he's got a first down. Signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. A handoff to Fournette. Brent Urban there to get him down.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
Yards remain on second down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
Hijo de la puta madre.
So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. On second down now.
Come on with the hit. I'm lining this, motherfucker out.
6 yards to pick
up. Kelly, get that ball back.
It's been working out back in 4 tenths of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive.
We're playing traffic. He's white.
Because my last thing got 400 or something.
A handoff, four down running left. And one of the first times tonight he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage.
Kennedy.
Trayvon Diggs getting the tackle. Parker, you get about 20 coaches on your payroll.
It's some type of candy. It's like a.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Sorry about the candy.
Ready to throw.
Woo! There we go, baby. Drop that shit in the end zone.
You know they make after payment like that, like this one? And this one's asking for $7.
It's a... Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity. They'll try to punch it in before that, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3. Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game.
If you think about it right now in this season opener, it's third and goal.
Back to throw, Brady. Eluding the pressure right. And it's
Wow, Maddie, wow.
Sorry, you did DAL?
Yeah.
Oh, whoa, he's 1 point. You know, if you can last this, these last 28 seconds without him winning, I think he will win.
I don't know how the fuck he got that shit, but...
It was a fumble, wasn't it?
Don't forget the extra point. Here's something good.
Oh, yeah.
We are tied here in the fourth quarter. Cowboys offense. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game. You don't want to do anything crazy right now.
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward. Okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out. Get to overtime and try and win it there.
All right. We'll see if they do just that. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two.
Again, it's Elliott. Come on, come on.
First down as he's able to work his way out of bounds with 14 seconds remaining. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Missed tackles may doom this team.
I just had a bad flashback. That's why I'm sitting up here with you right now. You've got to tackle him inbounds. You've got to wrap him up.
Now Prescott.
Oh, come on. He had that. Fucking Amari Cooper, man.
Well, so much for getting separation. No chance there. Locked down tight, forcing the incompletion on that attempt.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. To throw, Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb.
Wow. And
picked by Pierre Desir.
Oh, no. Well, at least y'all are tired.
Final whistle blows, and we need some extra time here. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game.
Overtime.
If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball that gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
I'll bring it up here. Yeah, push
it. And no return here to begin the overtime session. That'll be a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win them.
And I think teams around the league.
I don't know how he's getting fucking cut by a leg like that, man.
Going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get a field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now. The ones who are doing it best know they need to go down and attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. On 2nd down, Bernard. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29. As a fan of the NFL, for an opener, you can't ask for much more than this overtime in week 1.
I know it's hard to believe that some people may not have been watching our game, but I'll bet through social media they found out this one was snug and getting into overtime, and they flipped over here in a hurry. This is fantastic. If you're a fan of ball, you love these types of games.
Now a first throw here in overtime. Flushed out right.
Come on, baby, that's pick.
Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And 4th down now coming up. The temptation to go for it probably there. Always is, especially in overtime. Gotta punt it, though.
I think you're right. Yeah, I think that you absolutely have to punt it away and trust your defense, especially play a little field position here. But you're so right about the temptation. Another way to satisfy that, though, line up in punt formation and fake it. That's another way to get it done.
Brady gonna go on 4th down. This will be caught by Brown.
Oh, get the fuck out. Man, this is the simulation, bro.
There in overtime, but it pays off with a 1st down.
This thing is going for on his foot.
Throwing now is Brady. Over the middle, he finds
God. That should be his thick fumble, but it's not going to be.
Chance of success as they did on that play.
On 2nd down, it's Jones. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let it pick up a 1st down. Keep the sticks moving.
Down, it's Brady. Got a man, it's Brown.
Wow.
And past the
fuck out of here, bro. I mean, I'm playing the flats.
The Bucks passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down. Shaping up to be a very efficient opening drive here in overtime.
And can you feel the tension building? Because I'm feeling it. All right, I've got the sweaty palms here with each play because of the enormity of what's going on. Each play means so much in overtime, and they're handling it well as this drive continues.
On first down, Bernard.
One off.
Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at them and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense, and on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. Yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Again, it's Fournette. And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten the yard down to the 16. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settle it, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys, poking, clawing, breaking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to. Opening drive of overtime and now facing a third down at six. Big play coming up. The shotgun to give to Jones. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I definitely like the play call. You don't expect it on third and five, third and six, do you? You expect a pass play. Had a little courage there to call the run, and boy, they were successful.
And they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4 yard line, second and goal. They'll give Fournette another crack. He's into the end zone for the touchdown and a game winner in OT. We needed extra time to decide this one. The rushing score in OT finishes it off, but all throughout, really just a great game to witness.
I agree, and the whole time we were watching and working on this game, I had it in the back of my head. We could get to overtime. Just the way this game went, the ebb and flow of it all. And then to get there and finish it what I would call old school way, a running play, because in today's NFL, we throw the ball to ring the bell, don't we?
Not there. They ran it in. And again, just a great, great game that we bore witness to. So for the Buccaneers, they begin their Super Bowl defense with a victory here in the Thursday night opener. And they'll get the weekend off now as they get a little extra time to prepare to face the Atlanta Falcons. Meanwhile, for Dallas, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they will try to get back in the swing of things next week on the road. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.